Pombos, ratos, esses animais que a gente está mais acostumado a ver nas cidades, eram, na verdade, animais selvagens que aprenderam a viver com a gente e que agora estão sendo mudados por essa convivência. Esses bichos estão evoluindo. As áreas urbanas, que por um lado são hostis por causa de atropelamentos, impermeabilização do solo, falta de cobertura vegetal e por aí vai, por outro lado, podem oferecer comida em abundância, água e calor. Para entender essa evolução dos bichos urbanos, a gente conversou com o Menno, que é um biólogo evolutivo dos Países Baixos. Menno Schulthausen é pesquisador do Centro de Biodiversidade de Leiden, nos Países Baixos, e já escreveu o livro Darwin Comes to Town. Em português, Darwin vem à cidade.
I think that we see actually evidence for that, that actually also some species are evolving to which previously were not able to live in cities because it was too different from their natural niche, from their natural habitat. But there are some populations of species of plants and animals that are changing genetically and are adapting to, you know, noise and pollution and people and traffic. And they're evolving ways. Sometimes they're also learning. Of course, mammals and birds, they can learn also things, but there's also lots of other species that I think are evolving ways to live with us in this new habitat that we have created. There are also species which I think are slowly changing, and they're actually moving from the suburban areas or the peri-urban areas, as we call them, where there is some human influence, but not so much. And they're slowly, bit by bit, adapting. So first, probably, they increase their tolerance to people. They increase their awareness of traffic, for example, as a cause of danger. Sometimes there's even, you know, changes of the way they look or the way they behave or their physiology. And bit by bit, they slowly colonize the center of the city. We've seen that in the UK, for example, with foxes. They are... they first started appearing in suburban areas, and now they're right into the center of the city. And when you measure the skulls of urban foxes, you also see that their skulls are evolving. Their snouts become shorter, their jaws become different because the diets, the food that they're eating, is becoming more and more human food. They don't feed on, you know, natural carrion or on wild birds or wild rodents anymore. They feed on leftovers from people, which is usually pre-cooked food. It's fatty or it's softer. So their jaws are actually changing and evolving because of this new food. It's very difficult to really separate the effects of learning and the effects of evolution, even in species that have been studied, because also, the ability to learn is also genetic. So the ability to learn can also evolve. And of course, in an urban situation where animals constantly face new problems, because the environment is changing all the time, because we invent new stuff and human society changes quite very quickly, the ability to learn can also become better because of evolution in these species, and that makes them learn more quickly. And the things they need to learn, for example, is to figure out, you know, very quickly figure out what is dangerous and what is beneficial. So one of the things that animals can learn, for example, birds, think of crows, but also squirrels, is to figure out which types of human food can be opened by them, you know, food packaging. You see that birds are very quick at learning to open, for example, these sugar packages that people leave on restaurant tables. They know how to open them, they know there's food inside, and they probably see other birds do that, and then they pick that up and they learn it very quickly. But I think it's also, so that is learning, but I think at the same time, you see that these birds are evolving to learn more quickly than their natural relatives. In a forest, you don't find new problems all the time. Once, if you know how to crack a nut, that nut is not going to change. It's going to be the same for thousands of years. So that trick, you don't need to learn new tricks every year in the forest.
As aves são esse exemplo de urbanização de bichos que é mais fácil da gente notar. Os pombos, por exemplo, estão bem à vontade na cidade. Eles fazem os ninhos nos prédios, nos telhados e nas marquises e dificilmente são caçados por outros animais e ainda tem gente que gosta de dar bastante comida para eles.